Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls 2 Morrowind, as brought to you by my amazing supporters. The first thing we're going to do here is go ahead and grab ourselves a Fortify Strength spell. Rage Fast, I mentioned that, yes to all, that you don't need the specific spell, you just need a Fortify attribute spell. So what I want to do is find somebody in here that will teach me, like, I don't know, Fortify Wisdom, or whatever, and we'll go from there. So will you teach me? Here, how about Charisma? Sure, Fortify Personality, there we go. Spell making, Fortify Attribute, and we want Strength, and it's gonna be on ourself, and we're gonna make it for a decent duration here, so I'm gonna aim for, we'll aim for 10 on the offset. I'm gonna be modifying this, but I wanna name it first. Strength Enduring. Okay, so how bad is this gonna get? If we want 10 points. Yeah. All right, so how about instead of that, how about for like a minute? Even that is, oof. All right, well, we'll try it. All right, bam. Okay, so I don't wanna see, high table. What I wanna see is whether or not this works. And ideally, this is recording properly. This game, the longer I play it, the more bitchy it's getting about recording. Okay, so our strength is boosted, we got extra carrying capacity, awesome. So that should help us. I'm really not going to be running around with it on all the time. It's going to be an, oh no, we're, you know, 10 or 20 points away from being able to carry all of this stuff. Yada, yada, yada. I've got better things. So we'll eventually have items that'll probably give us strength bonuses once I can do some enchanting. But for the time being, I'm not gonna worry about it. As I get stuck on the wagon. Reach Fest also mentioned that we can actually fast travel where we need to go from Aldrun. So if we can get there, we can get anyway. Actually, we can go here. All right, so we'll just fast travel to Morrowind from here. That's handy. We are in Aldrun because I'm an idiot. Anyways, this game's getting kind of bitchy about recording. I've had to change the recording for the last three episodes. I've had to change how I recorded it, and it worries me. So ideally, this is recording, ideally. Okay, so we go to the temple and read the plaque describing Vivek's taunting of Mehrunes Dagon. So we are looking for the temple, which is probably gonna be the biggest building here, if I had to guess. So pray, make sure it's not any of these, and it is not. All right, so I'm gonna guess it might be that one right there. We'll see. These giant bug houses. There's the temple. There's a shrine. I suppose that's as close as we're gonna get. Wow. The magic rock of Morrowind. Here Mehrunes Dagon held his rock high above the Dunmer. Vivek taunted Mehrunes Dagon so that Dagon threw the rock at Vivek instead of the people. Okay. Hey there. You're on a pilgrimage here, I may assist you. Do you want the blessings of the temple? Yes, please. Yes. Very well, stand still. And he lights you on fire. Drops a rock on you. Alright. Yeah. I'm gonna read the plaque. Alright, so is there an actual plaque, or is this, like, little scrub of text here the plaque? I don't know, you guys. Is there a plaque? Tell me about Vec. Lord Vec is the lover of both words and deeds and a master of weapons and poetry. Okay. That's just temple information. Can I have a blessing again? Sweet. Multiple blessings. Alright, so what I want to do now is see what this does for me here. It gives us sanctuary, which, and fortify attack, nice. Alright, so is that all we have to do? I have a feeling that's probably not. Hey there. I am an Hadra. If you're a pilgrim, read the inscription on the stupid rock. Taunt the Daedra. Your threats are weak like your flesh, mortal. It sounds like this is something we have to do. Continue with your insults and I long to feast on your marrow. Find words from one. After I kill you, I will rape your. Holy shit! After I kill you, I will rape your corpse. Don't worry, I'll be gentle. Like, fuck, man, you just took it to 11 there. And how'd that work out for you? I taunted the Dunmer at the Shrine of Morgana and he attacked me. Jesus Christ, man. This is Morgana and I am Brains Othril, Lord of... Lots of pilgrims come here to visit the temple shrine. Is there anything I can help you with? Do you need services? We have several priests, two at the Tower Shrine and one at the Morgan Outpost. We also have a veteran smith, master at arms, drill master, and scout at the outpost. Mance Andis at the Andis Trade House rents rooms and sells food and sundries. Okay. You guys and your magic rock. I wish I had a magic rock. Alright, so I assume these are just like lay priests or something. Alright, so we got a journal update from that. Leads me to believe that's probably what we were expected to do. So we're gonna go ahead and fast travel back and see if we're done. I'm gonna laugh if we get there and just get, you know, shit canned by the temple because we killed one of their demon servants. I'd laugh. I think that'd be funny. You know, you have ruined this quest line and shall no longer be able to progress because how dare you do a thing. Take me to Aldrun.
We make a special trip just for you. Say hello.
Alright. Back to some high action walking. I know you guys all enjoy that. Okay. Some Quama eggs that are sitting there just waiting to be stolen by someone more enterprising than I. Because you know those 5 gold that I'd make for them. Totally worth it. Hey there, Cliff Racer. I'm gonna just leave your corpse sitting there for all the other Cliff Racers. Hey there, I did in fact complete the pilgrimage. You made the pilgrimage to Morgan. It sounds like you handled Anhedra well. Since you've learned another of Vivek's lessons, please take this book as a gift. The Death Blow of Abernanit. Alright. Am I ready for advancement? Yes, we are now an acolyte. Do you have any more duties? Speak with me again when you have proven yourself to the temple. I have one more thing to ask of you, but you are not truly ready. Until then, speak with Uvu Laren in Ghostgate or Endrin Lethine. Lethin and Vivek. Alright, goodbye.
I am blessed.
I'm over encumbered. What? What's that book weigh? Holy shit. 3 pounds. It's worth 300, so it's probably a skill book. Yeah. Block skill. Death Blow of Abergonet with explains by the sage Geocratus Vernus. With explains, huh? Oh, come on now. There we go. See, that's why we have our Fortify Strength spell. It's a better feather spell. For 10 points of strength, we get 50 carrying capacity. And a damage boost, which is all well and good. Like I said, though, that's very much something that we will kind of probably try to stack, because I believe with enchanted gear, all of the modifiers, like stats and stuff, stacks. So ideally, I'll have, you know, we'll have a natural strength of 100, and then I'll hopefully be able to get it enchanted up to, like, maybe 150 or so. It'd be nice.
Same low price.
Alright, so take me to Balmora. We gotta drop off a shedload of crap at our house. Not really a ton, but a lot of books. It is what it is, and then we're going back to Vivek. And I just realized I could have just teleported myself here, but why would I do that? Then you guys would be missing out on the high action walking. We make a special trip just for you. Same low price. Okay, so once we are loaded in here, we must add to the stacks. So what do we got? We have the Pilgrim's Path. We have 4 suitors. Okay, we have Spirit of the Daedra. I'll start another stack. Need the boss of me. There. Hypothetical treachery. Legions of the Dead. And Deathblow of Abernay. Eh. Okay, I think that's all of our books. See, like, I love this. I love that they let you, like, stack books and stuff like this, and it actually works. Cough, cough, every other Bethesda game, cough. Oh, no. There we go. Close enough. This one's gonna be trouble, though. We've just got this, like, random ream of paper that's like slowly stretching out here. I'll eventually have it like leading over to my bed, but not yet. Okay. And in here, we will throw some enchanting supplies. And for whatever reason, I elected to pick up that Daedra's silver longsword. I guess just kind of reflexively picked it up. We're just gonna come out here and dump it like that. And now we go to Vivek. Yay. I'm probably gonna nap first. 9 p.m., so we will sleep for 11 hours. 8 in the morning. Better. We can see things. Kinda nice. Hey there, buddy. Take me to Vivek.
Where would you like
to go? Alright, where would you like to go? Not to Vivek, but alas, here we are. The city's much easier to navigate when you just fly everywhere. Hey, go acrobatics. Speaking of which, how are we looking towards our next level? We are at 9 of 10. You look like some heavy blade skill there, lady. Alright, so I assume then that we're looking for the temple district, which... Let's see here. Foreign Quarter, St. Olms, Arena, Redoran, Lalu. Naturally, it's on the other side of the place. High action gameplay, are there any gondolas floating around here? Gondola, I see you. Alright, where are you? Take me to the temples! Alright, I guess in that case, take me to the arena, and we'll see if we can get to the temple from the arena. If not, I'm gonna just kind of weep inwardly and pray for death. Okay, how about now? Temple, thank you. Best spending of 2 gold pieces ever. Okay, I see you over there. Freaking little shit city that's probably seems farther away than it really is. Okay, that's another thing, is like World of Warcraft does it too, where they make the world feel much bigger than it is by adding natural barriers like terrain and stuff. And so, you know, going from A to B, like you might have to walk around a mountain range. But if you flip the view distance up like this, you just be like, oh, it's like 20 feet off. It just doesn't feel like that. And it's kind of a clever way to design things. Alright, so we are in the High Fane, and who, I don't even remember who I'm looking for here, and yeah. I think it might have been this one. Do you have any duties for me? No, you're not the temple. You're useless to me! You might be. A holy woman here in Vivek is spreading the divine disease to others. You must convince Tanusi Veloth to leave Vivek City, alright. Tennessee Veloth is a holy pilgrim and well-loved by the people. Do not kill her unless there is no other way. Try and convince her to go to the Corpsarium before she spreads the divine disease to others. She is very devout and would be most easily impressed by some show of your devotion to the temple's teachings. Okay, but where is she? Alright, is it gonna tell me here? She has corpus disease and may spread it, but she's blessed and does not suffer from it. Okay. I must find her and convince her to go to the corpsarium. Endrin is her first name. Neither of you are Endrin. Man, they're gonna make the, oh, Jesus Christ, if I have to go through this whole friggin' city. And I believe Crimson Cavalier, are you Endrin? No. Crimson Cavalier mentioned that Ordinator armor is medium armor, which makes me sad. I was looking forward to running around sowing chaos in that for a little bit. He also mentioned that if they catch you wearing it, they go into like permanent I must kill you mode, which turns Vivek, in his own words, into a war zone, which is a clever way to describe it. Honestly though, at this point, you know, I want to know. I want to see if we can actually just freaking kill one of these assholes. Yeah. Vivek being a war zone. Ha! Thanks for the long blade skill, buddy. Did I kill him fast enough? That's the question. That nobody's gonna complain. Yeah! Screw it. He made fart noises at me, so he dies. So what does he have? Steel longsword and then the Enduro gear, which as you can see is where they shed load of money. As Julius Vandelf mentioned a couple times, good money. If you want to, like, non-alchemy way, you've obviously got to be pretty martially skilled to kill these guys, but yeah. So there you go. It is in fact medium armor. I'm just going to leave that corpse there. Somebody's going around killing ordinators. No! What'll we do? Who knows? You're not who I'm looking for. I'm looking for some plague-spreading wretch that's not the plague. Nope. Alright, I guess we'll do upstairs. The cannon offices. Nope. Greetings, Outlander. Ordinator, Hall of Wisdom, we've already been to. Okay, so I guess we're gonna loop around. Temple. Alright, Underworks will be next, I should say. Alright, Hall of Justice. Move it, Ordinator. Cannon quarters, we've been to Milo's quarters. Ah, yeah, we already popped this lock looking for this chick. Cannon offices. All right, so I'll check the Underworks, and then actually we'll pop into the Hall of Justice really quick. I think this is where all the Ordinators lurk. So, Office of the Watch. So she's probably not gonna be here. Like a barracks and stuff. So, knowing my luck, that's of course where she is, but whatever. All right, let's find, get out of my way, dude. Where is it? There we go. To the Vec Hall of Underworks. This is not what I was expecting. I was expecting like all of the other Underworks where it's just like a lower city. Oh, I'm thinking of the Waste Works actually, not the Underworks. Oh, come on now. RNGY. Oh shit. Why have you forsaken me? Oh god, I'm stuck in the water with Slaughterfish. And this Daedric Daikatana is ridiculous. Just friggin' ridiculous. So we'll go on and go up. Why are we stuttering? The game is not stuttering because like my looking is fine. It's our movement is stuttering for some reason. I don't know. Weird. All right. Outside in the temple, and now we must poke around and possibly find this woman. Hello there. Part of me thinks she might be just kind of wandering around outside.
Is there something Danso. I can do for you?
No, we are looking for Tanusi. It could be just about anywhere. This is great. I suppose we can ask around for her. Hey, Ordinator, I know you guys are assholes, but faith, law, and justice walk on. Okay, we cannot ask about her there. How about with you? No. You actually teach spells, though, which... look mostly useless to me, so that's good. Bye.
I can spare a few moments.
I do not. Yeah, this woman could just be anywhere. So, we're at 19 minutes. So I think I'm gonna call it here, and we'll just spend the next episode kind of searching around for her. Maybe we'll get lucky and find her early and not have to spend 45 minutes wandering around. If you guys know where she is, just drop it in the comments. I'm recording these day of this week, so I will work with whatever you guys tell me. So, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you all next time where the words are hard. I will catch you all next time where the adventure continues. Until then.